Hello, everybody. Josh Rubenstein here for another KP Candid Conversations. These are conversations that we have with the men and women on the front lines of healthcare talking about serious issues. Today, we're talking about gestational diabetes. This is an interesting fact. Nearly 10% of pregnancies in the United States are affected by gestational diabetes every year. Joining me is Paola Lopez, a registered nurse in Panorama City. I think first I want to know, tell me a little bit about your background. Why did you become a nurse?
Wow, that's a complicated answer, but I've always been into the sciences, into medical sciences. My mom is a registered nurse, but I actually started off heading more into the information technology route than wanting to be a physician. And I was actually job shadowing different healthcare professionals at Kaiser while I was in high school. And I just fell in love with the different things that nurses could do. So it took me a while to find my path back into nursing because I was so headstrong that I needed to be a physician, but I just could never let it go. So I actually didn't become a nurse until my 30s.
Wow. Yeah. And I assume in your 30s, though, you appreciate
Yes.
that journey. You appreciate where you are.
Oh, for
right?
sure. I mean, I always have the, oh, what if I would have started in my 20s? But I think that just the life experience I had gained by then made me a better nurse for my patients.
I love that. What do you love about being a nurse?
Honestly, everything, but mostly because I work in Panorama City. I love that I can really relate to the patient population there and that I feel that I am a reliable resource for the Latine community, but the community in general. I feel like we serve a population that really needs a lot of education and a lot of extra care, and I feel really proud to be able to provide that.
Wow, we're lucky to have you. I appreciate that. we're talking today about gestational diabetes. Mm-hmm. Tell me a little bit, first, what is gestational diabetes?
Sure. So gestational diabetes is diabetes in pregnancy. It's not much different from type 2 diabetes, but it's just different in the sense that women or people who are pregnant develop it while they are pregnant. And it can lead to diabetes after pregnancy, but for most people, they will recover from it as soon as they deliver.
Oh, so it is something that you get, but then you can get over it or get past it.
Yes, it might not be immediate, but for a lot of patients, once they deliver, their body starts to normalize back to their pre-diabetic state.
Is it pretty common?
It happens in about 2 to 10% of pregnancies every year. So depending on the population that you serve, you might find it more often, which is our case in Panorama City. We do have a high rate of gestational diabetes amongst our patients.
And is that because it affects communities of color more disproportionately with the rest of the population?
Yes. So if you're Native American, Hispanic, African American, Asian American, you have a much higher chance of developing gestational diabetes, along with other risk factors such as already having insulin resistance or high blood sugars prior to being pregnant, having a little bit of extra weight on you, or having a family member, especially a first relative who has diabetes already.
Why is this so serious? Why is this something that we really do need to pay attention to for all pregnant moms?
Well, it's nothing that's severe during pregnancy unless you have it completely out of control, but it's something that should be taken seriously because if you don't have control of your high blood sugars, it can cause the mother to develop diabetes once she delivers. It puts the baby at higher risk for developing diabetes as a toddler, a teenager, or even an adult. And during the pregnancy, if the blood sugars are not under control, it puts the mother at risk for having to deliver via cesarean section and deliver early because the babies can gain too much weight. And we're talking about having a 9 or 10 pound baby, which would be very difficult to deliver vaginally or just healthy in general.
And what kind of things do you do to lower the risk of this potential problem?
To reduce your risk of developing gestational diabetes prior to pregnancy, you want to make sure that you have your blood sugar under control pre-pregnancy. So having a physical exam prior to thinking about getting pregnant to see where you stand if you're pre-diabetic or already showing symptoms of having diabetes. which would include becoming more physically active, having a well-balanced diet, and making sure that you're checking your blood sugar if you are diabetic to make sure you're keeping it within range. Once you are pregnant and you do develop gestational diabetes, then it's pretty much the same things. Checking your blood sugar to make sure you're taking it or keeping it within range. A healthy, well-balanced diet, which we have a lot of resources to teach you how to do that. And following up with your OBGYN and your perinatologist as scheduled.
So you, I mean, you're on the front lines with this. You're with moms who are already, you know, scared, you know, excited, mm-hmm. all kinds of emotions going on.
Yes.
What's it like when you deal with someone who, okay, we've got this diagnosis. How do you address it?
Let them know that it is manageable. It is scary to hear diabetes because for some people, they do understand that diabetes is a serious condition. It's not something that should be taken lightly. But I tell them to know that they're in good hands, especially at Kaiser. We have a lot of great resources. We have nutritional classes for women with gestational diabetes. They'll be assigned a perinatologist, which will help them manage to make sure that the baby's developing well and not gaining weight too quickly. They will be set up with a diabetic educator to teach them how to check their blood sugar and keep it within range. So let them know that they have a lot of help, a lot of resources to help them keep it under control. And that even once they deliver, we're still available to help them get back into a pre-diabetic state. And if they end up developing diabetes, we have even more resources to help them manage it for the rest of their life.
Well, and that's the thing. I mean, I want to sort of point that out again. One of the risks, if it isn't addressed, is
yes.
being stuck with diabetes well after you've given birth, right?
Right. And even if it is addressed, there are some women who will develop it, even if they manage it well during pregnancy. That, again, has to do with what your risk factors were prior to being pregnant. And if you just have a history of a lot of diabetic family members.
And I did sense that there is that emotional component where you feel like you did something wrong. So I assume that you address that part of it with the mom as well, right?
Absolutely. Even though there are risk factors that you can help to taper down a little bit prior to being pregnant, at the end of the day, you don't have much control over how your body reacts to pregnancy and all the different hormones going on. So that is something very important for moms to know, that it's not their fault. It's really nothing they could have prevented, even if they did everything right.
And what does it mean for, second children, future pregnancies?
Yes, that does put you at higher risk for the second pregnancy to develop gestational diabetes again. But it is kind of a flip of a coin. It doesn't guarantee you that it will happen or that it will not.
Yeah. And I assume what kind of advice would you give to moms, parents that are just became pregnant or thinking about becoming pregnant, and this is a risk factor, maybe there's family history of it. What kind of advice do you give?
I would definitely consult with a primary care physician prior to becoming pregnant, just for your baseline lab exams to see if you are within target of your hemoglobin A1C, to make sure that your blood sugar is currently under control. If you're already pregnant, then that exam would take place then with your OBGYN. But if you have not become pregnant yet, then, and you know that you are at high risk for gestational diabetes or diabetes in general, just making sure that you prioritize your health first prior to trying to become pregnant so that you are as healthy as you can possibly be during your pregnancy, as well as your baby.
I assume you love this part of the job too, where you get to guide moms, future moms,
yes.
through this very scary but exciting time.
Yes, education is definitely something that I'm very passionate about because I think we have so many resources and it's overwhelming. So it's important to have somebody guide you through all that.
The one thing I did hear in everything that you've just talked about is that integrated model, kind of the secret sauce of KP,
yes.
right? Of
yes.
Of really all of this wraparound help.
Exactly. That can be overwhelming, right? If you don't know where to start or if somebody can't help guide you. But that's the amazing thing about Kaiser. We have resources from the beginning to the end and everything in between. And it's very important for us to help our patients utilize it to their benefit.
Paola Lopez, registered nurse in Panorama City. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time. We're lucky to have you. And again, I look forward to talking to you in the future.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.